Hello guys, welcome to this tutorial. I will show you the newest Adobe Premiere Pro CC and the needful basics you need for this software. If you reveal any mistake in pronunciation, help us with feedback comments. Check the video description for the index of what is explained here. Before going on, you must know that this software works just on 64-bit operative systems. Do not try to find it for 32-bits. Premiere is a video editing software offered by Adobe. This often works with Adobe After Effects. Premiere is more focused on simple video editing and management. Let's start with opening a new project through the welcome window you have by default. Go to New Project. In the new window, set the main settings of your project, such as name and location at the bottom. Choose the kind of timeline through display format, if you prefer to see seconds or frames, then simply accept with OK. Let's see how the workspace is organized. The top side is dedicated to the previews, where it is shown the imported file opened or the full project instead. The bottom side is dedicated to files, info and browser on the left, and the timeline on the right. A Premiere project is composed by one or many parts called sequences. Each sequence has its own structure inside the timeline in separated windows. To import the files in your project, create a new sequence first. Just press Ctrl and N. A new window shows you all the available presets. Go to Settings section to set properties to your new sequence, such as frame rate or frequency. Change the sequence name at the bottom and then go to OK. Then add your files, dragging them in the timeline directly. They can be videos, images, or audio ones. Mind that images and videos are treated in the same way. Each sequence will contain the files imported in rows called tracks. Images are put in video tracks, and audio files are put in audio tracks, more at the bottom that can't welcome images, but just music or speech. Videos that have frames and sound occupy a video and a soundtrack in the timeline. Visible and sound parts are indicated through a V or an A letter next to the video file name. These do move always together. You can move them independently right-clicking and going to Unlink. To better distinguish files, they are represented through a unique color. On the left, you have the project window that can list all the files you need in your work. You can list here all the images, videos, audio tracks, and plus the sequences created. To quick collect files here, just drag them here directly. You can open any file at any moment you need. Just double-click on it. If it's a sequence, the related one will be shown in the timeline. If it's any other file, it will be shown through the source window in the top left corner. Press space to play or pause the player, or just use the buttons at the bottom. The playhead sets the placement in time, described through the two times on the left and right. The orange one says the time passed by, whereas the white one the total duration of the file. In case your computer has small memory or processor, it is important to reduce the quality of the previews shown. Just click on the gray rectangle you see on the right and choose between full, the best quality, or half or quarter. Very useful is the photo icon. This lets you save the image of the video frame that is shown at the moment. Let's now see how to work through the timeline. The timeline is composed by video and audio tracks that you can add, delete, or rename by right-clicking. You can eventually delete more of them by selecting more than one single track. Selection is made clicking on a file. Files selected are shown in white color. To make multiple selections, just click and drag, creating a marquee area. All that falls inside this will be selected. Otherwise, just hold the Shift down and click on the files. The selection is made clicking once more. Next to the track name, you have the eye and the lock symbols. The eye means that all that is inside such track is put visible. In audio tracks, it is used the M and the S buttons. The M means mute and makes silent the whole track. The S means solo and simply mutes all the other audio tracks to make you hear just the one interested. The third slot is the lock option. If active, all that is inside the locked track can't be moved or modified. The click on the timeline will set the playhead at a certain time. The preview above will show you how the sequence looks like in the timeline. This is actually what you have once rendering the video. Press space to make all played and stopped. The options in the preview window are exactly the same found in the source window on the left, but referred to the project and not to a file linked to the project. On the right you find the decibel meter or the dB meter that simply tells you how the sound layers are in intensity. Make sure that the color never gets too much red, which means to have it very loud. Layers are modifiable as well. Drag them to move them along the same track or in other tracks. Drag the edges to change the layer's length. Keep in mind that you can stretch images as you want, but this doesn't work with video or audio layers. These have a beginning and an end, so can't be looped or stretched more than their natural length. If you want to loop the layer interested, just paste next to such layer its copies. You can cut copy a layer interested pressing Ctrl and X and Ctrl and C from your keyboard. Paste action is done through Ctrl and V, and the layer will be pasted right after the playhead in your timeline. Pay attention where to paste it. Layers that are in the same track and get overlapped get cut and reduced in length. Make sure not to have overlappings if you want to avoid such. You can delete the layer selected, right-clicking on it and going to clear. There are some more extra buttons on the left. Usually you are going to work always with the selection tool on, the first icon in the list. You will use the track select tool to select all the layers inside a single or more tracks, just click on them. Rate stretch tool simply changes the playing speed of audio or video layers in order to adjust them. Just drag the layer edges to see its effect. You will use the razor tool to split any layer in two or more parts. You can view a layer better extending it. Click on the layer name and use your mouse wheel. If it's an audio track, you will see the waveform related to the sound layer, one for each stereo channel. New options will appear, in particular the ones that manage the keyframes. Keyframes are used to change the layer properties in time. Let's see them. If the layer is too much short, zoom in. You can zoom in and out easily using your mouse wheel while holding Alt down. If the track is extended, you can see an FX icon next to the layer name. This sets properties to the single layer. Click on it. If it's a visible layer, you will have opacity, motion and tile remapping. The first one sets transparency. Motions rules anything about scaling, rotation and so on. Time remapping changes the playing speed. In sound layers you can edit intensity under volume and the balance between left and right channels through the panel. Once an effect is applied, the FX icon will turn in yellow color. Whatever is the option chosen, you will always have a straight line upon the layer. If you don't see this that much, drag the edges of the track to enlarge its height a bit. You can change the value of the property chosen by dragging up and down such line. Check the preview window until you are satisfied. Keyframes do act in such line. Hold Ctrl down to click on a line to create a keyframe. This simply fixes the value of the property in the instant of time where it is set. So, if you put more keyframes, one following another, and in different values, you will change the property in time. Then right-click on a keyframe to delete or find the curve around such point. On top, you can use the last icon to choose what you see. In sound layers, you can choose to hide the waveforms, invisible ones, the frames themselves. In case you want frames to be shown continuously, right-click on your sequence name and go to Continuous Video Thumbnails. Let's now see how to render this project. To render anything from Premiere, select any file. You can export a single file in the project window or the sequence opened in the timeline. You just have to select what you want to export first. So, to render the full sequence shown, simply click on the timeline to select the sequence and then go to File, Export and to Media. The new window has all to render properly. Scroll the playhead to watch the preview of what you are going to export. The quality and the aspect are related to the render options set on the right side. Change format to change the kind of file. Click on Output Name to set name and location of the media to export. You can choose to export just visible parts or audio ones too. Very important is to know what to render. In search range, you can choose which sequence part to be rendered. Choose the entire sequence to render all in full, until the end of the last layer in the timeline. Otherwise, you can simply make a custom part by dragging the edges of the orange bar and setting what to consider. Then you can change the size of the video, although this is possible just with some formats. Just go to Video section and to Basic Video Settings. What you can do is to crop the source video to organize the sides. Just go to Source in the top left corner and use the Crop button. Remember that all that is outside will be covered in black. Then go to Export. If you want to learn how to render videos in HD, watch the related video in this show. While working, remember to save often, pressing Ctrl and S from your keyboard. Save your project giving it a name and a placement. Premiere CC projects are recognized as .prproj formats and can be opened just by Premiere. That's all. These are the full basics you need. If you want to learn how to put effects or render in HD, check the other videos in this show. Thanks for watching.